5 minute faith today is Psalm 37, verses 14 and 15. And this is running along with the theme of yesterday's as well. The wicked draw their swords and string their bows to kill the poor and the oppressed, to slaughter those who do right. But their swords will stab their own hearts, and their bows will be broken. So there's a challenge here and there's a promise. We're being told that people who are evil or who are given over to the king of this world, they are literally physically trying to kill and harm people who do right. They are following their father, the devil, who 1 Peter says seeks who he can devour. But God gives us a promise in that. He says their swords will stab their own hearts and their bows will be broken. So the weapons that they have are not just going to be defeated, but they're going to be turned on them. It is hard sometimes in this world, and as we watch the world degenerate and go further and further from the truth of Christ, it's hard sometimes to watch the terrible things that are going on. I mean, I'm sure you've all been there. I know I have. There are things that I have seen or heard about that just make me weep. They make me feel helpless or angry because innocent people are being hurt, killed. And then we can get into fear because Christ tells us we're going to suffer because he suffered. And as we watch this world become more hostile and more rejecting of God and the Bible and Christianity in general, we all begin to reap that that worldly perspective. People make judgments. People work against you. People actively try to harm you sometimes if they believe that they understand where you're coming from. They think you're wrong. But God's going to make sure that victory belongs to him. If you look back in Exodus with the children of Israel crossing the Red Sea, God told them, go backwards and camp up there because then the Pharaoh's going to see that. He's going to think you're lost. He's going to come after you. And I'm going to use that to show all of Egypt that I am the true Lord. And so at first they were obedient and they did that. But then they saw the Egyptians bearing down on them. And this is a real and present danger. They know these soldiers. They know this army. They know these men are ruthless. They have watched innocent people killed, tortured, imprisoned, misused, violated by these men. There is no question in their minds what will happen if the Egyptian army reaches them. And if you read that whole story, and I'd really encourage you to do that, you'll see not only does God keep them separate while he saves the children of Israel, but he uses that circumstance that looks so dangerous and so terrifying to the children of Israel. He used that exact circumstance to defeat the enemy and to tell everyone else who had been listening to Egypt to show them the truth of where real power lay. We have to be willing to keep walking in God's way, to wait for the moment, the day he shows himself and the truth about his power and the truth about his victory, because he promises over and over and over again to do it. And here he not only says that he's going to break their weapons, he says he's going to turn their own weapons on them. So keep talking to God about that. Remind him when you're thinking about this today, acknowledge where in your world you're seeing that harm or those weapons being ready or even used against you and people you love. Remind God of this promise and ask him to bring it to pass. Christ is returning. Victory is coming. Let's herald him in. Ask him to do now what he's been promising for thousands of years that he will do. We know he's true to his promises. Hold on to them, cling to them, think about them, and remind him of them and ask him to bring them to pass today. I will see you next time.